Guys, I'm not ready. The applause was so big, we have to wait a second. Thank you very much. And I have to figure out what I'm going to do next. Where are we? I was in the Army, right? Oh, yes. That's how I spent my 3 years in the Army. And you still have to give up 3 years so you could laugh and say you had a ball. I joke and said I got a Purple Heart for tripping on a tuba in the rehearsal room. But I did give up 3 years of my life. But I got a lot of experience, and in its own way, it was fun. I would have rather been home with my family performing on TV. I got to come home many times, as long as I did it in uniform, because, like I said, PR for the Army during Vietnam, they needed it. So I would come home and do a show in uniform, and they'd get some publicity, and I'd get time to come home and film a show. After I got out of the Army, it was actually kind of a low point for me. The world was changing. The war was raging even more. The King family wasn't performing as much. We went from Father Knows Best, and I don't mean that in a male chauvinist, the TV show Father Knows Best, to Married with Children, where the parents are the dumbest in the family, and the smaller and the younger the kid, the smarter they are. I mean, everything just, Martin and Rowan laugh in the shows. I mean, it was just very different. You got music, it was getting darker and things like this. Just to tell you about my weird childhood, Dick Martin and Dan Rowan from Laugh-In. Does anybody remember Laugh-In? Well, Dick Martin was dating my mother. My father died when I was 5. So Dick Martin was my babysitter for a while and would bring jujubes over. And I remember my mom had been out of town. He flew us down to LAX, Los Angeles Airport, to pick her up. And we had jujubes and we came back. This is like the 50s. And we said, oh, mommy, can Dick stay over and spend the night? You know, I mean, just, she's a single mother. And it's like, shh, you know. Anyway, we had a very strange childhood. But I came back, and I had not been living the way that I should. When I got old enough to kind of tell my mom, you know, I'll go sometime. I don't want to go to church now, you know. And so probably when I was, what is that age? 15, 16, 17, I don't know. And I pretty much, I went at Christmas. You know, to appease them, and I was in the Army for 3 years, and I got back here, and I was sort of lost. I needed a steady job, and I needed to change my life, and I did get a job. I got a job at Universal Studios, a Gopher, you know, the logo, literally Gopher, the coffee and donuts, or whatever they want. I worked my way up to, I was there 9 years, but during that time, when I was at my all-time low, I knew I wanted to make a change, but my brother got together with a guy named Doug Stewart, and they wrote a little thing called Saturday's Warrior. Some of you may remember that. Lucille stole this part of my show earlier on when she talked about it. It's okay, Lucille. But they cast me in the part of Todd, which was interesting because Todd was an artist in the play, and I was an art major. I wasn't doing it right then, but I was an art major. He was lost. He was looking for something. I was lost. I was looking for something. And all of a sudden, I found myself around all of these beautiful, cute, fun LDS kids. And at the same time, I met my beautiful bride in Burbank, California, just over by NBC at a steak swim meet. Neither one of us were in bathing suits, we were just there. And so all of these wonderful things are happening to me. I never thought I would find somebody so sweet and get married in the LA Temple. And certainly the way I was living at the time, I didn't expect it. But Saturday's Warrior came around, and it, for us involved in it, and I think for some people, it revolutionized some of the music for the youth and things in our church. People were bringing their kids, we saw people crying, and they're having more babies, and I met someone, they said, this is my son Todd. And I'm like, well, wow, that's a part I played. But anyway, it really affected a lot of people. And I guess that was a time I had, what do we call it, your own adult conversion, is that what you might say? Sometimes when you're young, maybe you have a great testimony, maybe you do it for your folks, I don't know. But I kind of did it for me this time. I was, what, 23, 24? Anyway, I was doing Saturday's Warrior, and it was wonderful. I just saw the light again. He wrote another play shortly after that, and it was called My Turn on Earth. And there's a song in My Turn on Earth that I like to do that kind of, well, it says what I needed to do at the time and what I was going through. my fingers.
That says it all, doesn't it?